Hi friends, today we are going to see what is cloud. And if you are a beginner in cloud computing, the first thing you need to understand is what is cloud and how you are going to work on the cloud computing concept. So before you understand the cloud, you should understand the server client model. Okay, so if you are watching this YouTube video, then the YouTube video is coming from the server. And your desktop or mobile, which you are seeing right now, is became your client. Okay, so this server always need high compute power like CPU and RAM. The same scenario applies right now. Okay, if you have your laptop and you have your data, maybe your personal data or your any photos, then if this laptop crashes, then you cannot access your laptop. You have to buy a new laptop and transfer the data. If your hard disk is not corrupted, if your hard disk is corrupted, then your data is lost. Correct. So whereas if this server goes down, maybe due to various reasons, this server can go down. One of the reason will be electricity power down. So high compute utilization, high CPU utilization or RAM utilization, so it may crash the OS related issues, network related issues, and any disaster like if you have wind or if you have heavy rain or if there is any issues with the place or data center where the server is located. So we need to have high maintenance for this, right? Basically, if the server goes down, your YouTube is not going to work or your laptop is not going to work. That is the reason we are going to the cloud computing. Okay, so what does cloud computing does? So it has a vendor. You need to buy from the vendor. Basically, you need to go with on demand. You can, instead of purchasing a server, you will go to on demand virtual machines. Okay, and it is actually pay as you go. And it will be hourly charges. So how much hour you are using the server, you will be pay for it. You no need to take care any kind of activities, like you no need to do anything. The power shutdown, the CPU utilization, OS related, network related, disaster related, high maintenance, everything will be taken care by this vendor. Right now, for example, you have AWS, which is Amazon, and you have Azure, which is of Microsoft, and you have Google, okay, which is GCP, Google Cloud. So you can purchase an hardware from them, and you can run it from your local. I mean, you can host your application. For example, in this case, whereas YouTube is an application. To understand this very pretty simple case. You think like you have a laptop, right? Right now you have your laptop and you are using it for long time. You have some 2 TB of data and your laptop gets corrupted. And what happens, if you have a lot of application, your laptop performance also will go down. Okay, your performance will go down and as a result, your laptop is gone. Your 2 TB data may loss, or otherwise you need to transfer to the new laptop. Okay, otherwise you need to transfer to the new laptop. Whereas now you can have a cloud VDI, which is virtual desktop interface, and you can have a simple laptop as your client. Every time you will connect here, all your applications and data will be onto this machine. Okay, when this laptop gets corrupted, you can again access your data from your VDI. So So this became stable because all kind of these issues will be sorted out by the cloud vendor or cloud provider who going to take care of for your system, and you're going to pay for it. Even there was a issues, they're going to have a team to settle out. Basically, you going to use another machine. Okay, now right now what happens, you can have 16 gigs of VDI, but here you can have only 4 gigs in your client. Because this client is just going to connect with your VDI and you are going to have all your activities here. Even your laptop get lost, you no need to be worried, because this authorization will be going to be a multi-factor authentication with a token. Okay, even if your laptop got theft, they cannot able to access your VDI because it needs a token authentication or some method of OTP to access this VDI. So you are safe. So this is how now cloud is became in this virtual world or in this globalization. We have lot of data and we need to keep it in some way safe, and we also need to ensure in case of hardware failures or such things, our data is not lost. And we need to ensure that if you have a server, you need to maintain lot of things and you need to pay lot of cost for the maintenance. So cloud is just giving you a machine, and we are just going to get a machine immediately on demand. You need 100 servers, 200 servers. You are not going to wait, or you are not going to pick with IBM or HP or Dell or whatever it is. And you are going to IBM, Dell hardware as a service also is available. If you want to buy the hardware for hourly basis, you are not going to pay upfront. You are going to pay as monthly basis, and how much usage you are going to do. This is what cloud computing means. The infrastructure is going to be provided by the cloud vendors, and you are going to consume your compute power. So we will going to see further how this compute network storage service has been categorized, and how this work as an cloud instance or cloud VM. I hope you understand what is cloud. And if you still have doubts, please do comment and I will try to give you the justification. If you like my video, please like it, and please also subscribe if you are watching my video for first time. Bye. Okay, just not only cloud, we are going to see other topics. You can see in my and also please. Okay, bye.